أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله حد الأمانة ونصح الأمة وجاهد في الله حق جهاده حتى أتانا اليقين أما بعد فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار أما بعد إخواني قال الله تعالى في القرآن الكريم إنما المؤمنون الذين إذا ذكر الله وجلت قلوبهم وإذا تليت عليهم آياته زادتهم إيمانا وعلى ربهم يتوكلون الذين يقيمون الصلاة ومما رزقناهم ينفقون أولئك هم المؤمنون حقا لهم درجات عند ربهم ومغفرة ورزق كريم قال الله تعالى في سورة الحجرات إخواني إنما المؤمنون الذين آمنوا بالله ورسوله ثم لم يرتابوا وجاهدوا بأموالهم وأنفسهم في سبيل الله أولئك هم الصادقون إخواني, in this short khutbah, inshallah ta'ala, what we will mention is the most precious thing in life. I came here a few months back, I remember, and we touched on it on one side. Today, inshallah ta'ala, we would like to break it down a little bit further. The most precious thing in life is Iman. And the one who, fasiru fil ard, Allah says in many places in the Quran, go and travel across the world. Wallahi, when you deal with people, and people who don't have Iman, and the different type of lifestyles they live, their families, their friendships, their conduct, the way they treat each other, you understand the value of Iman. Many of us were always surrounded by Muslims, and you see good etiquettes to a certain level. But the most precious thing, the value of Iman, the value of knowing each person's limits and boundaries and expectations is the most amazing thing in life. Because what Iman does, Ikhwani, is it gives you design and structure. What Iman does is having faith in Allah and being near Allah at all times. What it does is it gives you a design to life. How should you live life? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives us design. Then after that is, how do we get around that design? Allah gave us a structure, day by day. What to do, when to do it, how to do it, where to do it. Most people in humanity don't have that. And so people live hayatan in a life. وَمَنْ أَعْرَضَ عَنْ ذِكْرِي فَإِنَّ لَهُ مَعِيشَةً ضَنْكًا Allah says, whoever doesn't have the remembrance of Allah, iman, in his life, he will live in a life that is tight and squeezed. It's like as if in another Allah says, a person who is not connected to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it's like he's climbing up on air towards the skies. How can anybody do that? Subhanallah. And humanity have now worked out that the higher you go up on elevation, the more you get tight and squeezed, and less likely to breathe. And everything that you do, everything in life, you will feel so much pressure. The value of Iman. And Allah, last time we talked about how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is teaching us the fundamental principles of the deen, teaching us what Iman is, where to get it from, how it's located, how it looks like, the one who has Iman, the one who doesn't, the one who has Iman where he ends up, the one who doesn't have Iman where he ends up. Teaching us the definitions of who truly, many of us claim, but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has set a standard for Iman. Yes, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has a standard for Iman. Look at this beautiful ayah that will go shortly that we read. Allah says, إِنَّمَا الْمُؤْمِنُونَ الَّذِينَ إِذَا ذُكِرَ اللَّهِ The people with Iman, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is mentioned, وَجِلَتْ قُلُوبُهُمْ Their hearts feel it. They're shaken by it. They are moved. They felt tempted.
وَإِذَا تُلِيَتْ عَلَيْهِمْ آيَاتُهُ
When the verses of Allah and the ayat are recited upon them,
زَادَتْهُمْ إِيمَانًا
It increases them in iman. It increases them in nearness to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
وَعَلَىٰ رَبِّهِمْ يَتَوَكَّلُونَ
And in anything in life, whatever happens, the people who don't have iman, their life is situational. Whatever situation they're in, they're affected by it. I mean, if they don't like it, they'll harm themselves. They'll harm other people. But to the mu'min, she always puts her trust in Allah. It's always with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Most things in life might not go your way, but you always have to have your trust in Allah. That's the attribute of the mu'min, but it doesn't stop there. Those are all within. What about on the outside? What do you see them doing?
الَّذِينَ يُقِيمُونَ الصَّلَاةِ
Allah says, they establish the salah. That is the lifeline of the iman. If there's no salah, there's no iman, ikhwani. Just like family. It's tough to consider somebody family if they're never ever there. But imagine if you're not there and you don't show up and you don't communicate to the one who has created you. What type of iman is that, ikhwani? Many of us, we don't take the salah serious. And we all know the famous hadith when the Prophet ﷺ was asked, what does Allah love the most? As-salatu ala waqtiha. Salah that is performed when at its time. Not later, not before, at its due time. Subhanallah. So, ikhwani,
الَّذِينَ يُقِيمُونَ الصَّلَاةِ وَمِمَّا رَزَقَنَاهُمْ يُنْفِقُونَ
Allah says. And whatever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given them, they spend in the way of Allah. They're not greedy. That's not the attribute of the mu'min. He's not stingy. He's not greedy. He doesn't withhold. Whatever he can, he puts forward. Whatever he can afford, he puts forth. But most people, and in the life that we live in today, it tells you. And the shaitan, he commands you of poverty and to be stingy and to be greedy. What about me, myself, and I and my family? I mean, I only have a few thousand dollars in my bank account. That's only for me and my family. Subhanallah. What are they missing? وَعَلَىٰ رَبِّهِمْ يَتَوَكَّلُونَ That if they spend in the way of Allah today, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give them double the reward, double the ajr. Then Allah says finally, with these attributes internally and externally, أُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الْمُؤْمِنُونَ حَقًّا Allah says, these are the people who truthfully fulfilled their iman. Everything else is just all talk. It was just all an image, a status. But the ones who come and follow this standard, Allah says they are the ones who have truthfully fulfilled iman. Subhanallah. What is their reward? Allah says,
لَهُمْ دَرَجَاتٌ عِنْدَ رَبِّهِمْ
Their status with Allah is high. They have darajat, high status with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
وَمَغْفِرَةٌ
And forgiveness. These people are not perfect. They are not angels. They will have mistakes, shortcomings. But they have next to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgiveness. And if Allah is here to forgive you, what else do you want from anybody else?
وَمَغْفِرَةٌ وَرِزْقٌ كَرِيمٌ
And for them is a noble means of living. Subhanallah. They will not humiliate themselves in order to get by in dunya. They will not go into haram in order to make a living. Allah will give them a noble rizq, something that is honorable, that they can use to feed their family and themselves and live life. The reward for the people of iman. But most, look at the opposite, the standard of the opposite, who people who are not connected to Allah or their iman is weak. Da'if. What is their standard, ikhwani? When they remember Allah,
نَسُوا اللَّهَ فَنَسِيَهُمْ
They forgot about Allah. So what happens in return? إِذَا ذُكِرَ اللَّهُ Whenever Allah is mentioned, they don't feel anything. They got to the level where they forgot about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. نَسُوا اللَّهَ Allah says, the crime they committed was that they forgot about Allah. That is the biggest crime that one can commit. Because afterwards, فَنَسِيَهُمْ Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgot about them. And who is out? Who'll be there for you? Who can protect you if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala left you alone? You're all for grabs. Everything in life that could harm you will come your way. And that's the thing. A person will live a life that is squeezed. Next attribute. When the verses of Allah are recited on them, it does not increase them in iman. It doesn't. They don't come with the other fundamental principles of Iman. Some of them, subhanAllah, the two saddest things in life. A man who doesn't enter the masjid, we're talking about Muslims, ikhwani. We'll talk about everybody else later. We have brothers and sisters out there who don't even come to the masjid, the house of Allah, the house of Iman. They don't come. إلا في جنازته, except in his janazah. SubhanAllah. What happens when a person goes in after his janazah and everything? People bring him to the masjid to pray upon him, to make dua for him. So some people, they don't enter the masjid إلا في جنازته, except in his janazah. Well, so what is waiting for that type of person, ikhwani? And a sister who doesn't cover up except in her coven. Some of the saddest things in life, ikhwani. A man's life is surrounded in the masjid, and a sister's life is surrounded by her modest. And the modest of a sister controls her iman. The Baytullah, the house of Allah, controls the iman of the rajul, of the man. If one of them is missing, it harms the person. It harms their iman, their relationship with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, which leads to نَسُوا اللَّهَ فَنَسِيَهُمْ. They forgot about Allah, and so in return, well, if you're not coming to the masjid, obviously, Allah is the last thing you're thinking about. And another ayah is telling us, the people with iman, no matter what they go through in life, الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَتَطْمَئِنُّ قُلُوبُهُمْ بِذِكْرِ اللَّهِ أَلَا بِذِكْرِ اللَّهِ تَطْمَئِنُّ الْقُلُوبُ. Allah is saying the ones who have come with iman, and by just that default of the standard that they have set for themselves, وَتَطْمَئِنُّ قُلُوبُهُمْ, Allah satisfies their hearts. No matter what in life, they will be satisfied, content, happy. Their life is not situational. That's how you know you're not connected to Allah, when your life is based on situations. Something happened to you, you're sick, somebody died, your family's hurt, you're broke. When your life is situational, and your emotions and your life is controlled by the situation you're in, you're rich, you're poor, you're sick, you're healthy, and that's the standard for your happiness, like the world that we live in today, that's what they tell you. More money, more fame, more women, more houses, more everything gets you happiness. Wallahi, it's not. The ones who got it, they don't live much longer. That's how the human is designed. When our hearts and our body is not designed materialistically. The more material you have doesn't make you happy. As a matter of fact, they say the more money, the more problems it'll create for you. In return, your life will be ruined. So, الَّذِينَ يُقِيمُونَ الصَّلَاةَ, Allah says, the people who don't have iman, they don't establish salah. وَمِمَّا رَزَغْنَاهُمْ يُنْفِقُونَ, and whatever Allah has given them, they're greedy, stingy. Khwani, we hear stories. A mother back home calls her son here. He doesn't pick up the phone from her. Allah is sad. A mother stricken. We just had a janazah a few days ago. There was a mother who died in a hospital. Her family's around. None of them came. SubhanAllah. What type of heart do you have to have, ikhwani? What type of heart? And when people go around, hey, janazah, somebody died. Let's put it on a few $100 together. Everybody just turns around and walks away. The people of dunya, that's what they do. So what's their reward, ikhwani? What's their reward? They get nothing in akhirah. And in life, they live a squeezed life. Then there are people who go farther than that. They sell their iman. At least these ones, نَسُوا اللَّهَ فَنَسِيَهُمْ. They forgot about Allah and Allah forgot about them. There are ones, you know what? Let's make a transaction. Here's my iman, my deen, my bond with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And in return, give me what I need of dunya. Money, wealth, fame, honor. Talk about that next, inshallah. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم إنا. الحمد لله مصليا على محمد وآله ومن تلا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in regards to talking about these type of people, ikhwani, إِنَّ الَّذِينَ يَشْتَرُونَ بِعَهْدِ اللَّهِ وَأَيْمَانِهِمْ ثَمَنًا قَلِيلًا. SubhanAllah. Allah is talking about the people who sell their covenant, their bond with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and their relationship and their iman thamanan qalila, for a small gain, a small price. A transaction, it costed them their dunya and their hereafter. But they chose the dunya. الَّذِينَ يَسْتَحِبُّونَ الْحَيَاةِ الدُّنْيَا عَلَى الْآخِرَةِ. They fell in love with the dunya more than the akhirah. So what's their reward? Allah says, أُولَٰئِكَ لَا خَلَاقَ لَهُمْ فِي الْآخِرَةِ. They will have nothing in akhirah. وَلَا يُكَلِّمُهُمُ اللَّهِ. And Allah will not speak to them. Subhanallah. وَلَا يَنْظُرُ إِلَيْهِمْ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ. And Allah will not look at them at the most important day of life. وَلَا يُزَكِّيهِمْ. And He will not purify them. وَلَهُمْ عَذَابٌ أَلِيمٌ. And the only thing remaining for them is the adab that is severe. Khwana, the brothers are saying, scoot forward. A lot of brothers are coming in the masjid, inshallah. Scoot forward if you can. There isn't a description like this in the Quran, Ikhwani, for people who treat their iman this kind. It has no value to them. It has no value to them. So in return, Allah gives them the type of reward that they deserve. While the other ones, the darajat, next to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, these people, they have nothing. أُولَٰئِكَ لَا خَلَاقَ لَهُمْ فِي الْآخِرَةِ. Look at the five steps, Ikhwani, of the process. They will have nothing in akhirah, number one. وَلَا يُكَلِّمُهُمُ اللَّهِ. Imagine what you have to do for Allah not to speak with you on the day when the slaves will enjoy the looking of the Creator. The day that we are all waiting for. فَمَنْ كَانَ يَرْجُوا لِقَاءَ رَبِّهِ. Allah says, the one who is hoping to meet his Creator, فَلْيَعْمَلْ عَمَلًا صَالِحًا. Have him do righteous actions. Be pure in the things that you do. It will lead you to a greater meetingness in front of your Creator. But these people, they chose a different path. They didn't have that desire in dunya. So in akhirah, there's no point. وَلَا يُكَلِّمُهُمُ اللَّهِ. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will not speak to them. وَلَا يَنْظُرُ إِلَيْهِمْ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ. And Allah will not look at them. And most importantly, وَلَا يُزَكِّيهِمْ. In return of all those things, what happens? Allah will not purify them. And nobody that is impure enters Jannah. Any impurity leads to naar, to hell. وَلَهُمْ عَذَابٌ أَلِيمٌ. And that is the final destination. عَذَاب that is severe. So, Ikhwani, in conclusion, we have to understand the value of iman. That is the greatest thing in life. Put time into it, Ikhwani. Study iman. Study what can get you closer to Allah, what takes you away from Allah. And study some of the key fundamental principles in regards to the concept. We put our own interest. Jahl is not an excuse, Ikhwan. You can't be ignorant of these things. Put time into what gets you near to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, into perfecting your salah and your ibadat and so on and so forth. Those are some of the key things in life. If you're missing that, you're missing Allah. Everybody wants the good life. Everybody wants a good life, a good hereafter. But not everybody's willing to work for it. You have to be willing to work for it, Ikhwan. And that concludes our khutbah, inshallah ta'ala. Hopefully, that gives us some things to take away from the khutbah, inshallah ta'ala. We have to be people of action and not people of talk, Ikhwani. And the most precious thing is the iman. ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار وأقم الصلاة.